call to order, May 16th, 2016, Municipal Billings Committee. First order of business, as always, delegation of the meeting clerk, everyone's favorite part of the agenda. Willie, you look like you're willing to take notes tonight.
Second.
Thought I saw.
That's what everybody else steps back.
No, you did a great job last time.
Yeah, everybody told me you'd be all night for the job.
You get that? Willie has help. Watch the video afterwards and catch up.
Willie has a helper too, so.
Do we have any previous minutes to approve tonight, gentlemen?
I did not complete them, I've got them halfway done from last meeting, but as I did that, I realized that we have Gary's minutes from the, what did I say?
19th.
19th, that were never approved, so we want to, I can make more copies and we can approve them at the next meeting, or?
Yeah, let's look at them next time then. I think that's okay, right?
Sure.
Timeline for that. Okay, so Gary has minutes, if we could just make sure they're distributed.
I distributed them last time, but.
Yeah, I got a copy of them.
I got a copy here.
Those are the ones you gave us, oh, okay.
We just never approved them.
Has everyone looked over the meeting minutes from Gary?
I have.
I looked at them after the meeting.
Yes, I'm fine.
What were the dates of those, Gary?
Huh?
What were the dates of the?
The 19th.
19th. Okay, do I have a motion to approve the minutes as written for the 19th of, that was April? Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Discussion on the minutes, comments, questions, anything for Gary? Hearing none, all those in favor of approving the minutes from the 19th of April?
Aye.
Say aye.
Aye.
Oppose, hearing none, so we've got those approved. Dan, if you could just get yours into us and we'll get those on the agenda for next time.
Yep.
What was the date of yours, Dan? It would have been the last minute.
Want to say?
5/3.
Third.
Okay. Okay, we'll get those on the agenda for next time. I put a placeholder here for an update from our liaison from the select board, so I don't know if there's anything particular, Jerry, you want to go over tonight?
Yeah, I have a couple things to let you know of that, you know, kind of progressed from town meeting. The first is there was some, at least three other contacts that were made to us regarding properties in the center of town. So we got the one property, kind of clarified what it was for, and it was a relatively, it was, the number was out of the ballpark of what the town was looking to spend for that. But subsequent to that, there's been three other people with properties that allegedly would qualify, and I assume that the select board will be going out for rebidding for a piece of property in the center of town. And one of them is a director of butter, so it's really good news for all projects that we're looking forward to. It was, I guess it was a letter submitted, but it wasn't formally presented in the bid process, so when it was received, it kind of, it didn't make it to the front of the line, so.
Okay.
And it's going to be vetted, and it's going to be redone, and I think it's good news for everybody in the town of Hadley, at least to have, to bring clarity to some of the questions that hit town meeting floor.
Is there a timeline for that?
I don't have a timeline for that yet, and I assume that the select board meeting tomorrow night, where will be at least discussed. I don't know if it will happen yet, but it'll be at least discussed.
Okay, and no action items for our committee in respect to that RFP?
No, I think, you know, I think we're going to be able to go with the rebid process, the bid that you guys signed off on to, with that one, and we'll go forward from that.
Great.
Okay, we're talking a little more about North Hadley Hall, I think, tomorrow night, and other proposals that have been made. I don't anticipate that there's going to be a finite answer on that yet, but if somebody would like to give me some direction as to how the buildings committee would like it reflected at the meeting, I'd be more than happy to voice your questions and concerns. I think it was rather obvious the last meeting that you guys were here, but I didn't ask your permission to speak on, to the select board about how you feel about what should happen with North Hadley. I think that is a general overall view of it, but I think in light of some new information that's coming in, that, you know, people want to, again, vet all options that are available to you and then go forward from there. So if you guys want to ponder that or think about it, or have me bring back to you any new information that we have tomorrow night.
Okay.
To the next meeting that you guys have.
Right, right. What's the committee's thoughts on that? I know I have a plan that I resurrected that shows a fire station location on that parcel, which is reflective of Mr. Michkowski's concept. And this was something I did like a year ago that we sort of shut down. But do you want to have that discussion now and maybe summarize our thoughts for Jerry to discuss tomorrow night? Or would you rather just wait and see how the select board approaches the subject?
I have some thoughts on it, so
yeah,
you don't mind.
No, not at all.
You know what, though? It's not, I'm showing up tonight kind of not preparing you, and it wasn't an item, agenda item. So if you, again, I'm not trying to push anything along, and I don't want anything brought forward in a non-thought-out process, so.
It's general thoughts.
Certainly.
You know, we've talked about this right along, that we always thought that the substation would just be a minimal building initially that would be expandable. That we would just do it at what we need for now, at a minimum cost, just to get the job done that we need to get done. But it would be built well, but with the idea that it could be expanded if need be. It sounds like the proposal that's coming forward is quite a large building, taking up a lot of that parcel. And my thought would be to keep it smaller, make it maybe two bays, an office space, whatever's needed. And then, because we don't know if that building is always going to be in the need that it's going to be, you know, where it is. You know, we're talking about a full-time fire department at some point in time. Will they still need that? And then we're coming up with a different use for it. So, but not only that, it would take up a large portion of that green that's there on top of the parking. So keeping it minimal, allowing some greenery, maybe some access to the pond because it's smaller, that kind of thing. So that would be my only concern. Not maximizing, but minimizing. And that's the only thing I would say about that.
Mr. Greenbaum had, at the last selectmen's meeting, the concept was brought forward to him as to whether or not he would entertain any such thoughts. And he was going to bring us back information. He was thinking about it and possibly bringing it back to us. But I think that begs another question, and conceptually a possibility of thinking a little bit outside of what we normally think about and how we do this. If you build a courthouse in the state of Massachusetts, the government doesn't build it. If you build a post office in Massachusetts, the government doesn't build it. A piece of property receives a document that says this is what we will be interested in renting from you. Let's, on the outside of it, think about a little different way about it then. So if Mr. Greenbaum buys that entire piece of property and we submit to him what the minimalistic view is that we'd like for a fire station up there with a long-term rental contract or a lease to purchase option available to him, the reason the state does it is because they can build buildings for half of the price of what it is when it goes out to a public bid. I mean, it makes perfect sense. So if Mr. Greenbaum buys that, Mr. Greenbaum's willing to and looking to offset some of his cost. It saves some of the green space. He has enough parking for himself. He works out a deal with the church so they get the opportunity to park the cars when they're looking to park to it. This could possibly be a win-win situation for everybody. And I don't think we ever conceptually looked at it like that or brought it to his attention.
You're proposing like a private-public partnership. Yeah. By which Mr. Greenbaum would construct the facility and then lease it back at a 50-year lease or some duration lease.
And then he could also in the future convert it into something else if it no longer is of use to the town.
Correct.
We have an example of that right down the road. Right?
We've got a courthouse right in town with it. You have
he has fish and wildlife too.
Fish and wildlife you have. It's just a different way to look at it. And you know, I think the substation up there, if you take, and I don't want to monopolize your meeting, so I won't be quite
this is pertinent.
If you take the last house in North Hadley on the Sunderland line and compare from East Street to that house, and you take the last house in Hockenham from the fire station to that house, it's within a quarter of a mile of the distance between the two. Now, I know North Hadley may be a little more populous in the area, but I don't know whether the substation, if a full-time fire department was built, would necessarily be an absolute necessity. If we could get the times down and Chief Spanknebel was happy with it, and we did eventually get the fire station that was able to accommodate it, I think both ends of towns are very similar in distance from where it is. So whether or not a substation, a permanent substation up there is necessarily, I don't know. I know certainly everybody's leaning towards one currently, you know, with, until, you know, the finalized plans get done. And again, you guys are the ones telling us, and we're listening, that it's, you know, you're talking about 5-10 year projects here. But again, if you go back to the process, let's look at a building that would fulfill the needs of the town for the next 10 years, something that would be of use to Mr. Greenbaum in the future. Look at a long-term lease with him for 10 years while we're formulating our entire plans, and then possibly go forward with something like that.
There was one thing that the chief has mentioned many times, why he wanted something up there for the fire department, is because right now, as an on-call force, mostly on-call guys during the daytime are up there. And they've consistently got to the scene before anybody else. So that was one of the primary factors that he said. And also, whatever you build, it could be some place that can be utilized during a disaster for backup. And that's what we generally have, very archaic-wise, in the North Hadley Hall, but it could be something. Yeah, I think that the time that we've all spent has been very, very productive. Some people think that we really haven't been productive because they see us more as a ping-pong ball going back and forth from one thing to another. But all in all, it's been extremely valuable to get the consensus, some ideas of what we all are perceiving, what can happen. And it will all come into place if everybody cooperates and stop pointing fingers at everybody and saying, somebody wants this, somebody wants that. And let's just try to figure out what would be the best in a shorter time frame and a longer time frame. It could very well be that that might be a pretty good solution to it, but we have to also figure out what the need is and try to figure that out.
I mean, to that point, this committee is not going to make any more recommendations as to whether you need a full-time fire substation. We've listened to the chief. The chief has, even as recently as last week, had to re-explain to your newest select board member that they needed a fire substation there. So, I mean, you know, that's gone beyond, and it's gone into the strategic plan that Molly and the rest of the select board started to formulate, which is great. So we can only focus on what we can do. And referring back, and I'll catch you in a second, Andy, but back to some of the initial concerns we had about that site for use as a fire substation, because I looked at it and said, well, you're right, we don't have to build a tremendous big, you know, full-scale fire substation there. We could do something small. It doesn't lend itself too much to expansion. That was a primary concern of the committee. Other concerns had been at the time that the sight lines were lacking for pulling fire apparatus out onto 47, blind curves and backing in. With a fire substation in that location, there's no possibility of going around the back and pulling through, so backing in would be something that would have to be taken care of, and it would be a concern. Also at the time, the Historic Commission had told us they were going to put a preservation restriction on the open land as well. So that would prohibit us from doing anything with that parcel in terms of building. I believe that was not the case. Ultimately, they did not put a historic preservation restriction on the property, only the building. So that negates that issue. So, I mean, to that end, you know, and you guys can, maybe Jerry, this would make sense for you to take this, but this was something we put together which showed a two-bay fire station on the site, using what I believe was the correct setbacks for side lots and front lots and all of that, trying to accommodate some parking for the person that would purchase the North Hadley Village Hall property. And that's the real concern, because there really is very minimal parking if you were to take the entire lot and provide that for a fire station. Even if the person that bought that property owned the whole parcel, you would still have to divide it such that you had fire station parking and apartment parking at the village hall. So that's a bit of a concern, I think that would have to get worked through, but I, looking at it again today, just rehashing it, it actually works pretty well. As David said, the two bay, apparatus bay, design works better than a three. A three really pushes the sides to the point where the parking is not gonna really work out that well. But I'm really interested in your public-private partnership kind of idea. You know, I guess the concern would be that Mr. Greenbaum may or may not have the capacity to construct something that's gonna cost probably in the millions, even if it's just a temporary building for the fire. Maybe it's not that, you know, I don't know. If we were gonna build something that was a real fire station,
can only ask,
we'd be talking real money.
Yeah.
And you know, if he was looking at something that's more like a Morton building or something like that, that could ultimately be repurposed for another purpose.
I think it's a great idea to sit down with him.
It's really intriguing, yeah. It is. And I also think that historic preservation would have some concerns over building something that's overly temporary looking there in the center of the village, and I think that would be a concern for all of us to maintain the historic character of that neighborhood. So
and
that
would
Joel, be
something it would be a concern
at.
For him too.
Yeah. Yeah, right.
I would think we'd want to build something that would fit the neighborhood, get that historic look, so maybe we're looking at clapboard siding as opposed to the Morton building, so it it would blend in, and then it would be, you know, conducive to future uses.
Yeah.
And a lot of that is what, now we're hopping over to the, but a lot of that is what, if we're looking at it, you know, how much of this is going to be a long-term solution for the town, is this, we don't want to repeat the mistakes that we've done over at Central. Are you going to build something that's going to last for a long time? Are you going to have a long-term lease? And yes, they can certainly make a colonial-looking masonry building with, you know, but we don't want to, certainly don't want to put 30-foot gables up on the top of it. But getting back to the original point that had been made is that, and without pointing fingers here, but trying to get direction on what we do with the fire station has been a lot of what has been, we've been wrestling with trying to get out the recommended scenarios, because that play has a lot of, you know, we have a lot of contingencies on which way we go, because it's such an integral part in the few buildings that we really do own and the properties that we have. We don't have a lot of options. If you move one piece, there's a cascading effect. So what we do at Central versus whether or not we're going to do a North Hadley substation, all these things play out in what this committee, and I don't want to speak for everybody, but in my mind, what this committee would be able to accomplish going forward and what our directive is to meet the objective for the select board. So having that big question answered would certainly play out a lot.
It was our first play out of the gate, you know?
Right.
It seems so obvious.
I mean, I agree with Andy.
Here we are 2 years later.
We have spent a lot of time on this, and now it seems like the selectmen have changed their direction, which if that's what it's going to be, then let's look forward to that and we can work on that. That was our, you know, plan B. But we also have an option of, and that Tim has been working on, of another place that we can rent. If we're going to end up renting a place or something temporary, we have another option that would still allow that field to stay with the property and be open space. And, you know, if that's the direction that, you know, we want to go, then that's an option that I think we should look at too.
And just to piggyback on that real quick, the concept of a North Hadley substation, and that's something for you guys to decide, actually where you put it, you know, sure you own the land, but is it necessarily the best decision to put something in there that is site constrained, that does step on the open space in North Hadley, that does not go with what the North Hadley Village meeting, they wanted to maintain some open space up there for the sake of saving the purchase of the land. Now granted, that's certainly cash out of the taxpayer's dollar, but in the big scheme of things, the land purchase relative to the building and all the other improvements is not you know, not something that should be taken lightly, but at the same time, I think it should be, you should consider whether or not that is necessarily the best location if you're going to go ahead with something like that. And I know that the chief had talked about better access down to, you know, the east end of Route 9 that could be accomplished at least two other locations, not, you know, a mile or so up the road.
Other comments regarding Village Hall? I did watch the meeting on YouTube from last week and your dilemma about whether you were going to resolicit the RFP or just the discussion with Mr. Greenbaum would be advanced, over the next couple of months. My only thought was if you rebid it, you may not get as good of numbers as you have now.
You've showed your hand now.
Right? So
it's not much of a number, so I mean,
right. No,
you didn't lose a lot.
It's not going to get better. No.
But, right. Yeah, you got to look at, I don't think you, people should not be focusing on the dollars. You got to look at the whole picture. What's the ultimate outcome out of what's being proposed? You've got the building. You got it under somebody's hands that really takes care of old buildings. You're going to have it historically preserved. You're going to be able to look at it. And, certainly the first proposal was meeting a lot of the requirements and the requests of the village. So, I mean, I just wish people would not say, oh, $72,000, that's ridiculous. Look at the whole thing. Like you guys brought up at your meeting, how much is it going to cost us to fix it up? And what will we ultimately use it for? I think putting $2 million into that building and not having a good use for it is a waste of money. It's reality. $72,000, yeah, everybody would love a lot more, but come on. He's going to put over $2 million into the building.
This is ground we covered quite some time ago.
Yes.
But it certainly bears repeating that this was some of the decisions that led us to this point, which put up that fall 2014 warrant article, which was to say, yes, it's not that we're going to gain a lot of money selling the properties, we're going to avoid spending a lot of money on that property, which we deemed not as the future use in that current building was not, didn't offset the cost.
And the argument is we can't save them all.
Right.
I think that has to be reiterated again and again. If you're going to save one, what building does the town want to save? If you can save two, what are the two? You can't save them all. And it's just way too much money. We're looking at $12 million. Just to put them back to what they should be, and that doesn't even include any big modifications for the need. So it's a reality check for people.
Well, I think you heard the board, the committee's opinions, Jerry, but I think we're also very intrigued by the public-private partnership idea. So.
It's a great idea. It's a great concept.
And I didn't come up with it. It was brought to my attention, too. So I'm still as dumb as I was when I walked in. I am able to reiterate the conversations that I have. So,
like I said, if we were going to, that's kind of what you were, we were proposing it as an option for temporary. There could be something else, which would be a good proposal, but in a different location and allowing that piece of open space to stay with that property.
That's right.
Piece of people.
We do have another game plan up there if we need it, and we got something.
Okay.
We have to.
Anything else? October.
That's about it.
Okay.
Is that a copy that I could have by any chance?
Yeah.
If it's a copy, I'd
like to. I didn't show it to any of you since we looked at it last year, but I know the camera can't zoom in on this or anything, but this is the parcel. So what I did was I did a 50-foot setback from the street line. 15 from the property line, 35 from the top of bank, which was per the Conservation Commission, and then I tried to accommodate a modest parking lot for North Hadley Village Hall, 15 foot off the building, and another 15 foot from the parking lot edge to the proposed property line, gives us another 15 foot side lot for this building, which is, in this case, the full build would be three bays, 4,200 square feet, but I showed two bays that this way. And about 2,500 square feet of support on each floor. If we could go two floors, or we could do just one floor.
But if the proposal is for six apartments, you're going to have to increase that.
Well, I wasn't aware of the proposal being
at the time.
And
yeah,
at the
but
time,
it's a good concept.
We'd have to look at additional parking somehow. capacity.
Right, you have an extra bay in there too, so.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Well, and that's why I showed it as a dotted line, because maybe you don't build that, but the bays I showed were very, very large. You know, they're 16 foot by 50, I forgot if they're 60 feet, but then there's another additional 6 feet between each bay and 8 feet on the edges. So it's spacious.
Where's the parking for the fire department?
I don't know. I didn't figure that out at the time. Honestly, you know, maybe that within this 50 feet of setback in front of the admin, or you slide the admin back.
Or put it
no idea. Put it over. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And of course, the other concern is no matter how North Hadley Congregational Church works, there's always going to be an issue with them parking in front of that field,
yes,
whether that's a fire station or not.
Exactly right, because they fill up that whole.
Yeah.
Well, if it's a fire station.
Both sides.
It would be a concern. You're creating a problem. That's
all. Yeah. It would be a concern. There's no question about that for any parcel there.
You got to applaud Johnny's. You know, he's really trying to think outside the box. And, you know, being in Hadley his whole life, I mean, it's pretty hard not to get out of the box at some point in your life.
Right.
And he's trying to help. And I wish that he would keep thinking. It doesn't seem like it would be a perfect solution. It could be a temporary solution. There are more options, as Gary and Andy pointed out. And as long as we think through everything, you know, I'm sure we'll come up with something that's going to work. I hate to spend money on that North Hadley Village Hall and nothing becomes of it. I mean, that's what we decided so many, you know, a couple of years ago already. We were on that. We decided that you know, private dollars are, you know, spent on that hall, it's going to do it justice. Our public money is just going to be a waste. I think that you know, there's certainly a way to get out of the fire department solution.
Okay. One more question for Mr. Devine regarding this topic, because I didn't watch the entire meeting on YouTube. But
2 hours 36 minutes.
Yeah, 2 hours 36 minutes on a Sunday morning. But was Mr. Greenbaum willing to extend the offer? Is there an extension period here? Because I don't know what the, you know, what
is. Nothing's finite on it. It's all being discussed.
So, because, you know, as
in principle, he was, though.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. You don't want to have spent a lot of time ramping us up to this point to have it all tossed aside while while this topic comes back to the forefront, because it, you know, we explored it a couple of years ago. And
yeah. Okay. Jerry, anything else?
That's it for me. Anything for the board?
No, I mean, recognizing that we'll play some role in your strategic plan, we're excited to hear about how we can help you, and it seems like the right approach in order to understand how things work over the short and long term, particular, you know, the concern over buildings, but sounds like a really good approach.
Like I said, there was a couple of good things that came out of it. We got an OPM that we're talking about now. We're still talking about North Hadley Hall. We're talking about a possible another piece of property in the center of town on a rebid, which would be, you know, kind of bring a lot of the loose pieces to the matrix together. I think those are integral parts to having a little more success come fall or whenever we look to go forward with all the projects.
Also, a lot of the warrant articles and projects that were deferred from last fall and or the spring and now, of course, the budget items reformulation of the budget, those are things that we would consider still on the table.
They are on the table. It's just a matter of, and you're going to find this to be a consistent thing until the numbers are all. In the past, it's the budget process has been kind of a moving target, and the Finance Committee and the Select Board said this year, let's just try to pick a date and let's use those as our target numbers. We don't know what we're getting from the state yet for 90s or for Chapter 70s or any of that money, and it's always or what monies are going to be left over from the accounts once the fiscal year comes to an end. So for us to fund with an incomplete budget, with the budget being so incomplete, always, you know, tends to be a problem. So this year we picked, and I think Timmy will attest to it, and probably Gary as well, that the budget process this year was far less excruciating. We'll find out what our numbers are after the 1st of July comes, when the governor's budget finally does come up, and the town of Hadley knows what we have coming from the state. We'll be able to sit down and be able to look at real numbers and to understand what we'll have available to fund. Also, the refund will be in the capital planning that we get when we get the meals tax in. We'll have X amount of dollars in. For us to talk about spending it when there's, you know, $33,000 in the account is kind of, we have to rethink the way we do this, and we're doing that this year, and hopefully it's less excruciating for everybody involved.
Well, obviously, we've got a lot of projects that we put a lot of work into, getting estimates and design specs and the like, and these things become dated over time, and if they're, I guess the question in my mind is if these are worth pursuing again to make sure that, you know, these were a number of projects that the committee had in mind and recommended. And we can certainly, obviously we're going to wait till fall town meeting, but whether or not we're going to expend any energy on keeping those things alive until then. And it'll be, I guess it might be good to know whether or not we should, if there's a yay or nay or high side.
Keep your priority list. We can anticipate, you know, that there's going to be a significant amount of money in the account, certainly from the meals tax. We got the roof projects going to continue, and we'll finally get the roof put on. We got backhoes coming. I mean, I think it's a process, and I think we need to learn how to rethink how we deal with it. And when the money's there, we can spend it, but if there's no money there to spend, I understand the frustration of your committee not having it available to fund these projects.
The whole thing with the funding is reality, you know. Years ago, you had all those figures when you came to the Springtown meeting, and it wasn't a problem because the state had all their numbers together. It's reality now that they're not doing their numbers. You're lucky if you can get some of them by October now. And I think that's the game plan. We can't think about coming to everybody in the springtime with a list of things that there's no money. It's now, you almost have to be a year ahead of the game on some of this stuff. It's just the way it's going to always be. Yeah. It's not going
to
change.
That was never part of our purview to think about the numbers of it. Mm-hmm. We were, you know, our mission statement was to, you know, save one or more of the historic buildings, and, you know, the library came along with an opportunity to capture funds to, you know, get a library going with, you know, at half price basically, and so.
That's not what Andy's talking about.
Right, but our priorities were safety first, and that's where we were concentrating on safety first. So what can we do with public safety? We reprioritized to try to capture those funds, and, you know, now we're in limbo about it. So, you know, I would imagine safety first is still a priority.
Yeah, it is. But the thing is, we'll discuss that later. Budget is the budget, and what we are trying to bring forward. Projects for the spring. What we have to do is think about projects for the next spring, and then it fits into the budget plan. Then we can go for the fall town meeting to get all the funding and be prepared. So that's reality. It's just the way things are, and it is what it is. So we can perceive, hey, we're ahead of the game for next year. That's the way we should look at it.
The state balances their budget if they don't know what they're giving out.
Right. In the news today?
No.
They're not. But the reality is that their budget is only 0.65% away from what they're trying to do, I guess, is what they say. They say $240 million, but it turns out, you know, which is a mind-boggling number to we in the world of $16 million, $14 million budgets, but they didn't seem to be too concerned about it.
But there's a lot of other things that go into that money that we're going to be getting. Retirement, veterans, retirement, and OPEC, all that stuff OPEC comes in.
Yep.
So that's got to be taken care of. We're falling way behind in those areas.
We're gaining significantly. We put $250,000 in last year. The budget was brought to town meeting floor with $75,000 taken out of the school budget. And I think we'd like to take care of that as a starter item as well. But again, this is exactly the way we did it last year, and many, many projects got done. So it's a timing issue, and I...
Yep.
That's all it is a timing issue.
It's a timing issue.
They need to readjust.
Readjust that time.
We appreciate your support.
Yes, thank you. We're trying to do the best we can, too. And we know you guys are, too.
Right. Thank you, Jerry. Okay, I want to move into an update, and I'm sorry, normally we have the library a little bit ahead of this, but you've been waiting patiently, planning and design, and the trustees, Joanne and Allison. Just maybe get an update. I know we've had some good conversations about your survey, and David, of course, would like to sort of hear from you what's going on.
Well, I did miss the last meeting. It was out of town, so.
Yeah.
It was an important one, though, so.
Spirited.
Right, well, David, you were there to represent the building committee, and so was Stan, which was great. So really, we're trying to figure out our next steps. Obviously, the article did not pass at the town meeting, so we're trying to figure out what to do. The general feeling of the committee is, well, you know, it's really our responsibility to try again. We do have time to try again. The grant is not due until January. So the feeling of the committee was, you know, there were certainly enough yes votes. There's been, we've already, you know, we've gotten this planning and design grant. It would sort of be irresponsible of us not to follow through and try again and see, you know, why was this voted down. So there wasn't a lot of discussion at town meeting, which kind of hampered our understanding about why it went down. So we're trying to go out with a survey. Literally takes 2 minutes, so hopefully everybody here has taken it and pass it along to everyone they know. And really just trying to get an idea for people that voted no, especially some of the reasons that they might have voted no. And we're sort of collecting information from everybody as well. Right now we have 186 completed surveys. Some other folks have answered some of the questions. So we're getting a lot of good information. It's about 60% folks who either voted yes or said, if I had been at town meeting, I would have voted yes. 30% the sort of, I voted no or I would have voted no, and then 10% other people, abstainers or non-town residents, that type of thing. We'd really like to hear from more people who have said no, because that's what we're really trying to figure out. From our perspective, we would really like to hear from you guys as a committee how this impacts your thinking. So clearly some balls were rolling, you know, on your end. Now that we have this sort of no behind us and we don't know the next steps, hopefully we will come to some sort of idea at our next planning and design meeting, which is June 6th. The survey will close on the 31st of May, so it'll give us about a week to process it, and then we'll discuss what we see, and maybe that will point us in some sort of direction. But we would really appreciate, from your perspective, where do you see this going? Do you see this as, you know, a failure of the current situation, a failure of the design and location itself? Would this be easier for your process, the strategic planning of the town with respect to buildings, if we had a different site? What are your thoughts on this?
I mean, one of my concerns right now is what to do with Hooker School if we don't put the library there, because then that means as a committee, we're trying to figure out what we're going to do with the building. And currently, we really didn't have a use for it other than swing space,
right?
And that was it. So if we're going to have to maintain this building, now we're also trying to figure out how we're going to use it.
Yeah, so. And to that argument, you know, initially we did plan for that building to be swing space, and as such, we picked a roof which longevity is not a very long life roof, to be fair. You know, we took care of it for the 15 year max duration, and the idea that we would use it for swing space, possibly for Park and Rec or other functions that are going to move around. That was prior to us hearing from you and about your possible grant opportunity. So things change a little bit, but I want to hear from most of you tonight, because I know that the vote was divided when we discussed it. I mean, the Library Planning and Design Committee has done a good job of educating us on their concerns, their programmatic needs, site searching, and the results of test fitting the program to specific sites, vetting out that the library the existing Goodwin was not a viable option to fit that program in, you know. So, I mean, there was a long process that went on here, and we were very well educated through that process. And you know, we still were a little bit house divided in terms of our support the night we voted, but there were concerns over budget, of course, and there were concerns over the historic preservation of the senior or Hooker School portion of that property was a concern. There was a concern over the priorities that we held as a committee. I personally thought it was kind of, it forced us to move quicker on some of the priorities that we did have, which included the senior center. It just advanced that whole agenda far, you know, sooner, quicker than we had originally anticipated, and that was a concern, whether we could get ahead of you and do something for the senior center. So,
and that would be an ongoing concern. So,
right.
Even if we went forward with the exact same articles and it passed in the fall, it doesn't change that. You know, the train is still going to be going down the path.
Right. And to be fair, the committee, you know, we've been bogged down by a couple of issues and hence have not really developed a longer term recommendation plan that included all of our priorities. And as your survey indicates, as one of the options, you know, that is something that people may be concerned about, and I think they are. So those are some of the ideas I had, and I want to hear from all of you about your thoughts.
Well, I made a statement before that I thought you people did a very, very good job in what you did. But the only reason that I was concerned was that you were getting ahead of us, and we were falling behind because we couldn't get the space that you needed for you. So I said that I would have to vote no to halt the library there until such time as we could figure out what we were going to do with the other buildings and the other more important things that had to be done.
So I was curious, when you say halt time, what you mean in terms of time frame? Because for us, we're doing this to take advantage of a grant. We're not doing this to add money to the town. So I guess I'm not arguing, I'm just asking, what you did you mean till the fall, or do you mean years from now? I'm just curious.
I don't know, because one, we don't know where this park and rec is going, or the senior center is going, or the fire department is going. So until we take care of those three, and I stated that too, that those were right now more important, because we have to get rid of those before we can put you there. And that's why. So I don't know the timetable.
So for you, it doesn't matter where the library is situated, what the library looks like, or even what the library costs, because you're going to vote no matter what. Because until we have our fire department taken care of, however that ends up looking, we have a new senior center, and we have a place for Parks and Rec. So it doesn't matter. Like, as a committee, there's nothing we could do to get your yes votes. We couldn't move it, we couldn't redesign it, we couldn't...
Oh, yes, you could. Okay. You could redesign it. The only thing that I was against was the fact that the design we had was knocking down the senior center.
So if we had a new site...
If you had a new site, if you had a new design, so on and so forth. Okay, that's good, because now you can do your thing and we'll do our thing with the other important items that had to be taken care of. It's just the site.
Okay, so they said you preferred the site, and you were saying you don't. You said you preferred us using that site.
I think what I'll say is that we followed your process for programming and test fitting the program into the four or five alternate sites that you had available, and we agreed that those were the ones that you had available and should look at. And by default, that seemed to work out to everyone's, that was the preferable alternative, except for possibly the site behind the senior center. And I think we were convinced that it would strengthen your grant opportunity if you were to place it towards the forefront.
But David said at the beginning of the meeting, I'm not accusing, I'm just trying to, we're trying to keep straight.
And we're not one voice either, so we recognize that.
Right, I think that's why David asked everyone to speak, because I think there isn't one voice.
So David Waskevich said, though, that it solves a problem in kind of taking care of Hooker School. We're not accusing, we're just trying to listen and hear and make sure we know.
Right, it solves that problem, but it causes something else.
But Joanne, just be sure that we gave you several sites to choose from, and it just so happens the others were eliminated by default because of they weren't conducive to the library. So that we left this site at the Hooker School or behind.
Right, but what you said at the beginning of the meeting was that you felt this solves your problem at Hooker School.
It solves a problem, not this problem.
Not our problem.
Not our problem.
Okay.
A problem.
Okay.
Because it could be there for 10 years. At some point in time, we would deal with it, but.
Okay.
But that helps us understand your perspective on no.
That's correct.
Is that it links it and it causes other things to have to happen.
If the Hooker School wasn't there, I'd have voted for it.
Right. Got it. Is that okay, go ahead.
There's one other point I'll bring up in my list. It was, well, I mean, the timing was important, but pertaining to the reuse of the existing Goodwin property, I think this committee had some concerns over how we could repurpose that building. And we're already having problems fitting department program into existing buildings. It's really creating another problem for us. And you know, as you've indicated, that would be our purview to come up with a solution for that, and we've thought about it and haven't come up with a real viable. There's one option, but it's unknown if it would work. So that is a concern too.
Right, but anyway, that would be true anywhere we go,
right.
And so
that's true. Yes,
and unfortunately, we can't use our existing building and qualify for a grant. So, I mean, there's nothing we can do about that. So any place that we would go to apply for a grant to pay for part of this, we couldn't be using our existing. The only possible way we could do that, which I know we've presented in front of you, still involves knocking down the Hooker School, and we'd have to expand out that way. So that doesn't, you know, and then the design isn't as good, it's more expensive, that doesn't solve anyone's problems.
And there was a utility conflict that we had addressed.
Right. Yes, well, then we found that out after the fact, too, yes. So that, you know, so there are no other viable options.
And the other option is the fact that Jerry said there's three interested parties currently that may have land available, which could be another site.
Well that would be too late for
right.
us.
Right, we have to know by October,
unfortunately.
We could probably know by summer if we move this along.
Right, but we have to have our architect have time to design a building. That's the thing, is we don't have a design except for where we have a design for.
Yep.
So yes, I agree that would be great if we had other parcels from the beginning that we could have considered, but we don't. We're realistic about what we have to work with.
And we're stuck with working with what we have,
yes,
unfortunately,
exactly.
Which isn't much.
Right.
For options.
You know, we talked as a committee about priorities, and it was fairly unanimous that the priority had been to address public safety concerns, which may or may not be new buildings, but that had been in the forefront. And then the seniors had been a priority as well. And I wasn't convinced that we couldn't get ahead of you with a senior center project, given the time frame of your construction, which I believe was
spring
2019.
Right.
It's getting less and less likely we can do that as time goes on, and now we have, you know, other delays. But, we hadn't really done a great job of disseminating that information and those timelines to anyone besides ourselves, and limited discussions with the select board. So, I mean, that may have been a factor. If we had even given anyone a glimpse of the fact that we might be able to advance that program ahead of yours and do both projects. I'm not talking about the financial concerns, because that is one, and we're not really understanding that yet, but it seemed like it might have convinced a few that it was possible if we had.
So I have another question in terms of the senior center, and will you go through the same process with them of looking at the same lots? So do you see where my mind is going? Like, we're looking at lots now. Are they looking at the same lots? I'm just kind of curious what the situation will be when you deal with the OPM with the senior center.
Right.
Dan, is there anything you can report back on the conversations you've had there?
We're trying to keep options open. We're developing a matrix that would, you know, show available parcels in town. The existing lots that are for sale, lots that are, you know, maybe not for sale, but a good location. And once we gather all that information and put all of the different criteria in their holes where they belong, we can decide whether or not we have a space that's, or several spaces that you know, this could possibly happen. And all of the ideas are being floated around. The idea of putting it in an empty space in the mall, it's all being looked at. There's nothing that's off the table. The one thing that's for sure is that a lot of seniors came out in support of Article 11 because they thought for sure that it was going to buy them a senior center, when in fact it was just for an OPM. And the way the article was written initially was as senior center for a priority, and that's what they looked at. I don't think a lot of the majority of the people, as you indicated, were aware of a schedule like this could actually be feasible. And had they known, had they had all the information that we have, I think not only would the vote have been closer for a library, it may have gone overboard. It may have tipped it in their favor. Because according to this plan, the senior center would be up and running and occupied before that Hooker School came down to build the new library. And that, I mean, it's all right. It's a good plan that you had written up. And it still, you know, it puts us 6 months behind again. You know, and time is marching on, and the Russell School is deteriorating farther now. If we present the information as it stands, and you know what we've already decided that we're going to spend a bunch of money on buildings. We've voted for the OPM, and you know that's going to happen. This guy's going to be paid to come up with some ideas of what we're going to do, and we better have this stuff in order, or they're going to quit.
So if we reconsider, I'm not saying we are. We're just asking what to go back to our group with. Should we reconsider the same locations you gave us initially? Is that what you are saying are still the locations?
Well, I mean,
we should consider
the schedule that Dan is referring to. The critical path item is vacating the senior center as it exists today, and so there can be no overlap in the projects because of that. So I will just say that not demolishing Hooker School would allow us to get the senior center constructed, not worry about them not having a home. So in a perfect world, you would find another site, so we wouldn't have to worry about that overlap.
No, my question is, should we consider the same sites, or do you all of a sudden say we don't want you to consider the back of field anymore? We don't want you to consider, I'm just making up things, we don't want you to. Is there anything that this committee would not want us to look at?
Your committee has basically said that's not the best location for it. I think you guys have made that decision on your own.
Well, right, but if we have to come up with a plan B, right, then we have to.
But I think you have the option of trying to say, yeah, we can relocate. You can relocate almost any place. Then if you come up with a great plan, but on another site, you can also bring forward article to purchase the land.
She's asking if the sites that we all looked at are still fair game.
That's what I'm asking. That's all I'm asking.
There's only two.
And
there's only two.
There was the site of Russell School over where the old gym was. There was the site behind Hooker School. There was Hooker School.
There was Russell School itself.
And there was Russell School itself. Those were the four sites that they presented to us.
Yeah, we're just asking, so is there any reason to, I mean, honestly, because of our time constraints, we're not in a situation where we can go, we're not like the senior building committee. We can't canvass the town and look for great lots that might be for sale. We don't have that kind of time. So what we do is we need to go back and revisit the research that we've already done, but we don't want to revisit any of those things if you all say that is no longer an option.
Right, so that's what.
There's nothing that we've decided that's changed those possibilities, I don't believe.
I've got a question for Dan, though. Have they considered tearing down the senior center and building on that site, the senior center?
I don't think we've really, you know, but the last meeting we had was before town meeting, and they, you know, the seniors that I talked to in that room were convinced, oh, so if we vote for the library, this gets our senior center going right away. And they all understood that. Everybody in that room understood that. But I was told by seniors that were working voter registration that they were seeing so many seniors coming in and not knowing even what to do with the voter card. They were just there to vote for the Article 11 and they didn't know what to do. So it was a matter of not getting the right information out, I think. But is the short answer to your question.
I mean, it would be an inconvenience for a couple of years not having that site. They'd have to move out the temporary site.
Right.
But it would at least free up the back lot for the library if they wanted it. So that would still be an option if that decision could be made.
Right.
So.
And therein, if the senior center wanted to use the back section, we wouldn't need the senior center anymore.
And they considered that.
That's
a
consideration.
Yeah, they I mean that was the plan that we were sort of going after, was build the senior center back toward the Legion, and let the library have the front lot.
That goes back to the question of why did the Hooker School not pass then? Is it because people don't want to tear it down, or is it because of some other reason? So
I think it was to miss it, or
that's got to get figured out.
Not enough information, I think, and. I mean, that's just a guess.
I think basically it's a timing issue. I mean, we've been, you know, when we first got together, we picked all the buildings, and we, you know, you guys have taken such good care of Goodwin, we didn't, that wasn't on our radar. You kind of trumped our hand and pushed it, and granted, you, there's a reason, a good reason for it. You're getting, you know, half of the money, or possibly. And, but I think the other, you know, they wanted to see, the seniors wanted to see their building plans, you know, ahead.
No, it's at the same time, yeah.
Or before, you know, mm-hmm. And not contingent and not kind of like a smorgasbord where if you pick one, it might, mm-hmm. one may pass, one may not. You know, if I think, and I don't think, you know, like I said, we never planned on saving Hooker School. It was to be temporary swing space.
That's
and,
right.
You know, is our options, I mean, who, now there's some more property open up, maybe there's some other options to look at. I mean, we've also been looking at, you know, relocating the, you know, repurposing the public safety complex if we build a new one, if we're going to go full time. That's, you know, we've had different options and they're still, you know, all viable options. It's just it's basically a timing issue. You guys kind of pushed everything along and it's kind of like everybody else hasn't got anything set.
This is why we're asking you, would it be better for us to uncouple? So if we had another site, we would then uncouple from all of this.
I think it would slow things down, but.
Slow what down, Dan?
I think this plan was on track, and it, unfortunately, the way town meeting went, it's not.
But that
on track.
doesn't have to. You can still move ahead on that time schedule. It's just that you don't have
a lot of the
a sort of an external force, like because of our grant. Our grant is providing
right.
an external force on us,
right.
which is requiring us to do things maybe faster than we even want to do it. But to take advantage of it, it does. But it doesn't say that it's going to take away your time frame. You can still do whatever you want to do in the same time frame, but we wouldn't be forcing you to do that. So what I'm hearing from you is it would make our lives easier if you had another site. And I'm also hearing from you, there's no reason that any of the sites that we initially told you were available for consideration are now off the table. Is that correct?
That's correct.
So it would be better for all of you if we considered another site?
Not personally, but what?
No,
I think it would be better for the library, personally.
I think the survey's what's gonna tell you why it didn't pass. And if you look to the survey,
The survey so far says that.
So when you get the information back from the survey, you may find it being clear cut as to what would the people want, because those are the voters. They're the people who are gonna
We definitely need to look at that. But this committee is also in charge of making recommendations for all the buildings, so we wanted to make sure what their recommendation is. But you're right, Jerry. It might come clear. So far, it hasn't come clear.
Yeah, of course, a lot of it's all computer generated, so you've got some people that aren't on the computer that you're not gonna get getting their responses.
Well, we also are, going out actively into the senior center with tablets.
Yep.
It's in the Gazette again tomorrow.
Yep.
It was in the Republican last week. I mean, we're really, really.
Yep.
We really want to know.
We're having mailers.
We also want to achieve, and Jerry's right, but we also need as boards to agree with each other, Jerry.
Right.
Like, we all need to come as a group. So yes, the survey is very important, but also it's important that when we get to town meeting, that the select board and the building committee and we are all kind of on a same page.
Right.
I'm not sure that that's exactly true. I mean, as Mr. Dan Linkle pointed out earlier, if the needs of the community, and let me tell you that in a seminar at the MMA meeting this year, they say that's why these projects takes between 3 and 7 years to get done, because there's so much input that needs to, and so many citizens that need to be involved with the process and understand the funding and the priorities of the town and where we're heading for. The senior center is not coming before us saying we need a new senior center. The senior center is coming before us saying we need a new senior center because our building is going away and we need a new place. So they're not, they should have had town meeting because they were afraid that they were gonna be left without a building.
So they would be happy in their own building?
I would say they'd absolutely love to have their own building.
No, I mean the building they're in. They would be happy in the building they're in.
Yeah.
They want a new building, but they realize it's gonna take time. They were kind of waiting for us to go ahead and do this.
Okay.
As a personal timeline, I'm still going with the plans that we had, public safety first, which could affect or may not affect a possibility for senior center or park and rec if we relocate another building. If we can build one, if we end up building a new fire station for full time and the present one becomes available, we could possibly put senior centers, park and rec, or somebody else, build one building, you end up with taking
care of. Here's the bottom line,
okay.
And it's real reality. Everybody wants everything in front of them before they vote on it. And we didn't have the pleasure in doing that. I think our mission from the select board was first, which we've done, is go through the buildings and figure out where the departments can go. We basically said no departments can almost go in any of these buildings because there's too many problems with them. Then the ideal thing certainly would have been to come back with two plans are better than one. And say, here's two options. This is what we've come up with. Here's some concepts. This is the price range for them. And then people can compare. I mean, and when I'm saying those concepts, I mean with everything. Because we have a huge problem, much bigger than most towns have. Because all of our issues are all combined as to one major problem. All the buildings are very bad. All the departments are in buildings that they shouldn't be in. So if we can come up with two concepts, and we've talked about that many times, the two concepts. And one, just like Gary just said, our priority is the police and the fire. Are they in the best building for the future? And there's been a split here on that, but we need some direction from where are we going with both of those departments. And certainly with fire, that dictates to us what is going to be required in their new future building, be it a renovated public safety building that we have now, or a brand new one. When I look at the two concepts of use, and my position has always been and always will be, Police and fire are priority. That's the only thing technically this town's required to have. Senior center, park and rec, we don't need it, but we all do like it, all right? So let's look at public safety. What is the best fit for 50 years for them? Is it in the same building? We can look at that, and we can also do a new building. And then what do we do with the old? I talked about making a community center. Not everybody agrees with that. I do not like the idea of splitting buildings up. Why? Because it is more difficult budget-wise to keep them going, costs much, much more money to build, and if you have a bigger building, you can diversify that building much, much better. So certainly our best plan would be, if we had all the time in the world, to come up with those two concepts and with those dollar figures. And quite honestly, when I've looked at the dollar figures and I've talked to some people that are in this field, it's almost a wash on dollars. And it's a lot of dollars. We're talking $20+ million to do anything that we're looking at. So now then you can go back and say, well, what's the best fit land-wise, and what is the best way of going forward with the departments? Where do they fit best within the community? Certainly, the library fast-tracked this, and we felt that we could still be able to get something forward. We got, you know, we were like ping pong balls back and forth between a couple of people just pushing our buttons on doing this and doing that. And of course, we've always have in the background was the North Hadley Hall, because that's been number one directive to do something with that. So some of us have been working on that too. But our big problem is, quite honestly, you guys can go off on your own. I seriously think that it would make a better time frame for everything if you were in a on land that does not disrupt the rest of the possible master plan with all the buildings.
So when you say it would be better if we were on some land that did not disturb the master plan for the buildings, are you including this other sites that you...
Well,
so Russell School.
We all have seen the plan for the Russell School. It would be so prohibitively expensive and so gigantic to put a library there. It's really not likely that's what happened. But just to put them all on the table. So would it be disruptive if we use the back lot, if we use the field next to Hop? You know, so
it could be the field, but then we have to look at, you know, what is the from all the other departments, is there any disadvantage to that? I don't know.
And that's what I'm trying to understand.
I think that's where then you go to the different departments and say, hey guys, maybe this is an alternate plan, is a site. Would there be any issues relative to this site? Same with the...
But you don't perceive any issues right at this moment.
It certainly could detract if we ever did something. I shouldn't say detract, but it could make it a little more difficult than the design of something for Russell School, but I don't think it would prohibit anything.
And you're including the field behind...
I'm talking about the field.
School? You're including that also in this, right?
Yes, that's okay. What I'm talking about is the old field.
Yes. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
That helps us a lot to just hear.
Yeah.
Am I off direction on what I said, guys?
No, I think that's fair. You know, I recognize your time frame prohibits you from looking at the parcels that we may get from the RFP,
right.
And I really think there could be a silver bullet in there that would solve some of our problems. I'm a little unclear as to what your process is between now and fall, because your architect really can't do a heck of a lot with the building design, right, until it's approved by...
Nope. So I'll let me walk you through the time frame then. So we will close the survey on May 30th, the 31st. We're talking with other, you know, we're talking with you guys. I know Molly's engaging the select board.
from their end. We already know how the Historic Commission feels. They would prefer us not to demolish the Hooker School, so, you know, we've heard from some others as well. So then in June, we as a committee need to make a decision, because we, in order to apply for the grant in January, we have to have a design. So what are the requirements of the grant?
Meaning 100% construction documents?
No. Not 100%, but fairly close.
Okay.
We also need to have cost estimates for that particular design. So for town meeting, so in October, we would have to have a design, we'd have to have a site, we'd have to have a design. Those are the two things that we have to get approved. We don't necessarily have to have cost estimates. I mean, it's great to have, but we already have cost estimates, you know, preliminary ones for the existing building.
So when would we hear about these other plots of land that you're saying could be, are you thinking September? Are you thinking June?
That's up to the select board.
We'll be talking tomorrow evening regarding this issue.
Should be a priority though.
Yeah. It's the first meeting we've had.
Do you think that the concept, building concept would dramatically change, or most likely it's more a site plan modification?
So our building program determined how big each room, that document has been.
So you have that.
We have that.
But the, would the building change?
Well, it depends on the law. So we have to talk to the, I mean, we have to talk to the architect. That's why we're listening now, so we can feed everything you said to the architect, and the architect may say something different than, you know, we're not architects.
Right, so let me just give you a simple explanation. So right now, the design has the entrance of the library on the side, which
mm-hmm.
takes advantage of the site that we have. If we were to put it in the back lot, behind the senior center, likely there would be an entrance on, not on the side, but on the front, facing that parking lot, so it could participate in the campus atmosphere that you guys have said is a priority for the town. If it was in the lot next to Hopkins, there may be, it would probably be on either one end, you know, facing the street might be the best place. So we would have to shift the entrance and the look of it, but the size of it would not change, nor, as Joanne said, the size of the individual buildings. It would just be how it all fits
right.
with it. But yes, it is going to have to be a redesign,
modified,
and David could probably speak to this better than I could as to how much work. We do have an estimate of how much it would cost us. We have asked our architect if we have to have you, you know, draw us a new design, how much is it? Because we have to make sure we even have enough money left in the grant to take on this work. But it is another completely redesign. We would have to, you know, go out to the public, because we spent a lot of time getting public feedback on the design that we brought to town meeting, so we would have to do the same.
You're
thing.
At maybe 15%, 20% complete design plans at this time, right?
I don't know.
You would know more.
Yes, exactly, yes.
That's a
Phil
question.
Yeah.
You're at about
15%. Oh yeah, you might get an answer.
Not a whole lot been put into it other than the
concept drawing.
Right. Yeah. Right. I mean, it would be beneficial if you could look at the RFP and hopefully the select board will see to put this out promptly. We can maybe have some other options.
Yeah. No, that would be great. And we really just want to listen. I mean, don't think we came here judging. We came here.
No.
You're asking how we feel.
We don't want to waste the town's money. The town paid for the grant. They paid for us to do planning and design. So.
Which you're doing.
And as trustees, our job is to look for money. So we don't want to come to the fall and not have done all of our homework and do the best job we can.
Right? I mean, the other problem at this time is even if we have a piece of a parcel that we can decide on, we still have to bring it to fall town meeting now to vote on it, to approve it.
Mm-hmm.
In which case, the architect is
That's
designing a building on land that we don't even know if we have.
That's a good point.
So
mm-hmm.
it's really a lot of
things take time.
Taking a big risk out there.
Mm-hmm. Take a huge amount of time.
Yeah.
The gun to everybody's head, and especially to these folks, that is what is the timing on the grant.
That's how I feel. It's so unfortunate how that all came about. I think that if the information was out there and the town, you know, the voters had realized that this was a slingshot to get that senior center put in the front of the line, because the library needs that space now. All the money that you spent for that whole design process and all the time that you spent is water under the bridge.
It's not wasted.
Right, the
it's not wasted, but
yeah.
at the same time.
Was the initial work that had to be done
mm-hmm.
anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So we're not going to have to go back and do that.
Yeah.
And we got a lot of feedback from the community as to, you know, a lot of things we didn't have, like adjacencies of rooms and things like that. So, you know, we still have more information now than we did because we went through that process for that existing site with that existing design, so.
I've done a lot of these programming studies, and the more you do them, the better you get the end result to be. It really does make a difference.
It does.
Yeah. Good, so what else can we help you with, you know?
I think that's what we came here for. I think, you know, anybody's welcome to come to our meeting. I'll send out a reminder on June 6th. You know, so you can participate in the conversation. Obviously, it's an open meeting. It'll be posted as well.
Oh, Goodwin Memorial Library, so it's www.goodwinmemoriallibrary.wordpress.com.
For the survey.
Yes, and the link is right there. It should have gone out to the town email blast.
There's also a link on our NBC Facebook page as well.
Yep.
It says it reached 92 people, so I don't know if that means they all took the survey or not, but I think it helped anyway.
Who knows? And it's anonymous, so we're not tracking.
There were links from the Mass Live article. There's a link from tonight's Gazette article. So there are active links online. So if you're reading the Gazette article online and you want to take the survey, you'll be able to link directly to us.
Good.
And we are sending a mailing out to everybody who came to town meeting, thanking them for coming to town meeting and asking us to tell them more and giving them a link to the survey.
Yeah, we sent out 300 cards today to everyone who went to town meeting.
You said this was going to take 10 minutes here.
Sorry.
Yeah. You know, best laid plans, right? Well, you know. Okay, so anything else? We're good? Thank you for your time tonight, and we'll continue to broadcast the survey link on the website, our Facebook page, because I think there's some advantages to us also getting more.
And we should say we've told all departments. I met with Suzanne yesterday in the senior center. We're going to give those results to everybody.
Yep, we're going to make them
public. You know, if the select board could use that information, we're just going to make the information public.
Great.
Right.
Okay.
And pay attention to the selectmen tomorrow on the property that's going to be available, or that land that they're going to be exposing to the public.
Well, it's got to go back up.
Yeah, they can't say anything
expose
yet.
It.
Yeah, it's got to go up for another RFP. Nothing can get brought forward yet.
Yeah. Well, they'll know the land that's going to be.
No, we can't.
Not going to
can't do it.
Can't talk about it until it's presented.
The RFP has to go out first before any discussions. It's got to go out again.
Unless the land has been determined to be specifically advantageous for certain reasons. If it's an abutting piece of property, if there's something specific about it that qualifies it from everything else that could potentially come before you, then it can be considered first in line.
Okay.
And tomorrow, the old business number four is land discussion regarding that.
Thank
if that
thanks.
Helps. You're welcome.
Good. All right. Moving on. Thank you. Appreciate your time. Senior Center, I think, Dan, you probably summarized what you do know about those ongoing discussions with their planning and design folks. So nothing else to add at this time?
Not really. I mean, I went out, I visited the Northampton Senior Center. I mean, that's way bigger than we need, but it's the quality that we'd be looking at.
Have they gone out as a group to certain seniors buildings?
Not as a group, no. I think there's a couple of us who, you know, I don't go to senior centers, but I've been, you know, I got a couple on the list. I know Suzanne's been around to a few of them. Some of the other seniors have been around, but not as a group.
You're talking about the quality of the Northampton Senior Center? I would hope ours is a lot better.
For the site, it's well designed. But I talked to the director, and she indicated, things that she would have done differently and whatnot. So.
Didn't we have a design that you had drawn out for what it would look like on that backfield for the senior center, or no? I can't remember.
So the question was whether or not the two could both be on that same parcel of land. So we asked our architect, because Suzanne had said she was looking for a 10,000 square foot building, we asked him just to dump a 10,000 square foot generic building in the back lot just to show would there be enough parking, and there was. So it would be the same thing if we used the back lot and the senior center used the Hooker School.
Has Suzanne seen that?
Yes, we brought it, yes.
Okay, so she saw.
We've shown Suzanne.
Dan, at one point I had done a program for senior center. So it was square footage of all the individual rooms and everything.
Yeah.
That was done by them as well, but I went back and sort of back-checked it and made some adjustments and then actually put some square footage costs on there. So what it did is it vetted out a full cost estimate, very, very, very preliminary. But, you know, I can't recall the value, but I'll share that with you so that they can have that.
Okay. Yeah, that'd be helpful.
That's the one we worked on last fall.
Yeah.
It also been offered that their floor plan can be drawn up with that information.
Yeah.
If they wish it.
I thought I had that, and I don't. But, yeah, I mean, Northampton, she gave me some rough numbers. It was 18,000 square feet at...
18,000?
18,550 square feet at $5.5 million.
Got bigger.
No, that's the Northampton.
Oh, I'm sorry. They want it, and they want it big.
That's probably twice as big as what we need in town, because they have a lot of...
Yeah, we were about 10,000.
Yeah, it was like 10,000 square foot plan.
Yeah, and it seemed reasonable for the, you know, for the square footage, that seemed like a reasonable price. Of course, that's 10 years ago already, so...
You know, I'm probably going to get beat up for mentioning this again, but I continue to advocate for the possibility of a recreational center commingling in the same building with the senior center, and that has some programmatic issues I recognize, and it's been, you know, Suzanne has expressed her serious concerns over that happening, but I mean, you know, as a small town, we need to take advantage of our square footage, and there's some things that would be replicated if we were to build two separate facilities. So.
Right.
And you hear that from a few folks out there, but certainly the biggest thing that we're facing, of course, is resources, which obviously applies to all buildings that are out there. We can't do everything we'd like to do unless we get a really big benefactor out there. And so you've got to limit what your resources and it. Everybody wants their own space, but that's not the reality.
I mean, I've had several people say they'd like to see the library and the senior center combined, because that would work probably better than Park and Rec and the senior center combined. But I mean, what? I understand with your grant, that's
you can't. So I'm kind of confused, because thematically, I would think that Park and Rec and senior center are more akin than a library and a senior center.
They take quarry.
Exercise rooms, use multi-purpose
recreational
rooms.
Facilities are part of both of those programs, and as such, you would think they would be able to share some of the spaces.
Right, but less so the library.
And
we
less
only
so
have one meeting room, really.
Yeah,
but
there are concepts out there that other towns have used to make effective, but you know, that's just that idea has to run its course through here, and if it's going to gain acceptance, it needs to be met with an open perspective.
I'm only bringing it up for Jerry's perspective, because you know he's representing the select board, and I don't think they've ever heard this argument from us that there is maybe a possibility of
if you go around
economy of scale.
You go around Western Mass and you look at senior centers, half of them are located in Town Hall or in another structure, in another department. They're paired up with another department because that's the space that they have. And as I reviewed a bunch of the OPMs here, I mean, they've done that. They've just rejuvenated Town Hall and added on to it to make it into Town Hall Senior Center. And there's a bunch of that going on. It's just what towns have. We're a small town.
What you're seeing is these bigger community buildings that almost everything's in there, because it gives the ability to, like you said, use the space, but you're not, if you have separate buildings and separate parcels, you're duplicating everything. You're duplicating parking, mechanical, electrical, green space,
elevators.
The DPW, just keeping it, it just doesn't work anymore. And you go down to towns that have these community buildings, and they seem never to close. And everybody's in there, and there's multi-use rooms. And I go down to my daughter's, and it's just fabulous down there. It's just something, it's just great to go in there and see everybody just having a great time instead of being by themselves.
Right, bring the community together rather than...
Bring a community together. But we have to start looking at the dollars, and just don't duplicate everything. It's, and it's the only way it's gonna work.
Yeah, I mean, conceptually too, is we're so used to thinking in this linear fashion where we've got these separate departments, and there's a department head. Why couldn't there be a community director that's in charge of the senior center and the park and rec and has oversight over all of it and control?
Just like a mayor does for that.
That has been suggested.
You know, we're just so used to what we used to do, how about thinking about something different?
Yeah, it's a good idea.
Well...
That's 10 minutes.
It'll play out.
Yeah, it's way over 10 minutes. Okay, so thank you. Historic Commission is not represented tonight, so we won't be covering anything from there. Public Safety Complex Roof Bid Documents Override Materials. There is going to be a vote, and that's been scheduled after June 16th, I believe.
I think it's on June 16th.
On June 16th.
On June, it's officially on June 16th.
Is there any, what else is on that? Is there a backhoe and...
Yeah.
Is there another public safety vehicle, or?
No.
No, everything else is funded through the budget.
I think that's the only two things, correct?
OPM, is the OPM on that?
No.
No, it's already...
It's already funded.
I don't think that was funded in an override, but I'm not sure.
Is there anything you need of us to educate voters? I mean, the last thing you want is people going there and saying, I don't know about this, I don't know what this is. You know, we'll do something on our Facebook page.
Yeah, we can put something together on our Facebook page about why it is we're there looking for more money on that, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we've got, what, basically 2/3 of what we need, the other third. It's unfortunate, probably by the time we get it, it might be too late to get the roof on this year, but...
I hope not.
Hopefully we can expedite it.
I don't know, I was gonna ask today, I was so busy, I don't know, do we have to wait until...
They can't go out, you can't...
It can't go out until after...
I talked to David about it, he said, basically, you can't go out unless you have the money to do it. You're kinda wasting your time.
Well, how about if it comes in $50,000 less than the estimate? Then we have the money, and I just don't understand that.
I don't know, I'll get you an answer.
Do you know what I'm trying to get at?
I do.
Hey, we'd be lucky if it came in at half what the money is.
We have a backhoe quote, I can tell you that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So...
What's the difference?
And if it goes down in defeat, there could be some other place we can get the money, as we talked about.
The only thing I could think of is it'd be a matter of timing between when the bids are opened and when we have to enter into agreement. There's like a 30-day period.
But we, I mean, it's almost 30 days now.
Yeah, we're there, so, right.
So I would hope that we can expedite.
If you can't find the money, you're gonna have to cancel it, that's...
I mean, one of the thoughts was that we were gonna take it out of...
It might not...
It might not be there, but we, that was...
Just 'cause you got checks in the checkbook doesn't mean there's money in the check.
Well, that's what I had asked last time, so we can't...
There's one project committed to some of that money, and until we know the figure for that one...
But that still hasn't been resolved.
That one is out now and coming back again.
We still do not know what the bottom line is of that one line item, do we?
What one line?
The heating control system?
No.
The bids are coming back. We know what the price is, we know what we got there, we know what the money's there. That's we have a number, but we have a couple of things committed to that money that we don't have a solid figure.
And I think, right,
And that's why you can't spend it until you... You can't spend the remainder until you know what the first check is.
I'll have an answer for you tomorrow.
It'd be appreciated.
Yep, and we pushed that bid up, the vote is as early as we possibly could go. We pushed it up because we're concerned about the backhoe, we don't wanna put another dime into the backhoe either, so.
Yep.
We're looking for the support on that and for the support on that. But I assume that the additional $55,000 comes from a reasonable number that's been...
Yes.
An engineering estimate of the...
Okay, so...
From the company, the consultant.
And that included a contingency?
Not the same person that looked at the bid for the air, clarifiers, is it?
No.
I didn't hear about that.
Okay.
Okay, update from the OPM selection committee. Is there anyone that could update us on that, or
any information could be, disseminated at this point.
As you can tell by my stomach, we've been here since 6 o'clock. So we met for the first time today, and there were, let's see, public safety was, we had six people there, and we talked about how we were going to go through the structure of evaluation. Molly was going to modify a spreadsheet so we could apply it to what we're facing. There was some light discussion about general other attributes that would make one OPM preferable over another. So we scheduled our next meeting for next Monday at 6:30 at a location, most likely here. Whether or not there's we don't know if there's any other conflict. We put ourselves down on the calendar. And that is it. Molly was nominated as the facilitator.
Yeah. Okay. So how does that work with a timeline? When would we expect to have a recommendation to the select board for a selection?
The plan was to meet next Monday.
Okay. So that would be the last time.
Let's back up a little bit. Those of us received a packet about 4 inches thick with all of these things in it about a week ago, and then which said be prepared to discuss these on June 1st, and then over the weekend there was a doodle poll to figure out when the scheduling would be. Then yesterday we got an email said, how about tomorrow night? So a lot of us felt we hadn't given a chance to give full diligence to all of the information provided, so we asked that we extend it in a week. So we feel at that point we should be, I can't say that we're definitively going to make a decision, but
are you guys interviewing anybody for that, or you're just going to make a decision based on them?
We're going to make a recommendation to the select board.
We're supposed to recommend the top three.
But yeah, we also have to do some vetting on top of that, which is go out and we got to figure out who the top ones are, go out and do some reference checks, and then ultimately make a recommendation to the select board.
Do some reference checks.
Okay. Yeah. It's moving along. That's great.
Yep.
Okay. The land purchase selection, land purchase selection committee, I guess that's gone by the wayside at this point, since we're going to read.
We received one bid. It was $475,000 an acre. For the 3 acres that was there, it was $1,425,000, which was outside, and why chapter number 11 was pulled from town meeting.
Right, and it wasn't adjacent to the property.
Correct, and was landlocked.
Okay. Can I ask a related question?
Yes.
Does this put the North Hadley property that RFP that came in under this RFP, and the original RFP for any North Hadley land, which is what we're exploring with the other fire station,
has not gone out.
Has not gone out. So, where would that all stand?
It hasn't gone out.
Do you think would you foresee the select board submitting that RFP?
I don't know if this, does this board want to continue with that thought process?
That's an interesting question.
That's a pretty loaded question, as you could see from town meeting floor.
Honestly, and for folks at home, to be clear, that was a placeholder article that was set in there because the warrant closes in February.
Right.
And it had not been fully vetted. Why it actually wasn't passed over, well, at least it was a discussion point on town meeting floor, that was something out there. But there wasn't really a plan. We didn't name the parcel. It wasn't, I don't consider that to be a rebuke by town meeting. It was something that kind of sailed probably a little farther than it should have, and we need to make it clear that those
good analogy.
This was something that was really a placeholder that hadn't been fully fleshed out, and still the warrant went on to town meeting. So that being said, I wouldn't consider the issue dead because we didn't present the plan, and there really wasn't anything.
Before you go on this piece of property, I want to talk to you about.
Well, you know, I think we've got some ideas and some thoughts to talk about on the existing North Hadley Village Hall property, and Jerry's brought some interesting ideas here, and so I guess the question for the board and maybe ultimately the select board is, you know, should we also delve into programming that property any farther? And I think the answer is no, but
I think the RFP should go out, and they should explore what else might be up there, because we know that there's at least one other parcel that
you're saying an RFP for North Hadley specific.
Well, if we're talking about putting this fire station program together, I think it would, it's an excellent idea that we already own the property, but like we've talked about, it is another, yet another constrained site that we're looking at. And would it slow down the process much to send out an RFP to see if there was any other land out in North Hadley that might suit this need if the town was to proceed with the North Hadley substation program?
Jerry, I have a question. I mean, you're talking about three more potentials in town. Could the RFP be for land combined so we can see what everything is? Or do they have to be separated?
That's my concern, is it dilutes it, Jerry, if we do that.
So I think you have two different purposes. And when you throw everything together, nobody knows what you're actually purposing it for.
Okay. I was just kind of thinking for cutting down the process of doing all this.
The one that we got for North Hadley went through the, when we went locally, kind of got thrown right out because it said specifically on the bid process that we were looking within 3 miles of the center of town, and that doesn't qualify, so.
Hence, we'd requested two proposals back then, so.
Well, when we were looking at the North Hadley, first time around, it was for two purposes.
Right.
For the substation and also for land for Park and Rec. And now there's further discussion relative to the land that the town and the school will be owning for additional fields. I think there's got to be a discussion relative to that land and how it's going to be purposed and what it's going to be used for before we go forward with something around town for additional land for Park and Rec.
Well, I think that the reason that Park and Rec came into that land proposal was the opportunity to utilize CPA funds to buy the property.
That's correct.
And also to give one of the departments, the two departments that were being displaced in North Hadley, another place to operate. So I don't think that, but this is getting back to the public safety aspect of it, which was the lead.
The lead for
the
that
lead
property.
Program for that property.
That
and again, we know there's other property up there that has been bandied about.
Well,
so.
Even if we can use, and we can use CPA money for land for Park and Rec fields, I think there's got to be a discussion of what the need is throughout town. And what do we have, what do we need, and where the school and Park and Rec utilizes what fields. I mean, there's a lot of discussion.
I think it's a good discussion point, but I don't think it's part of the priority that we're talking about here, which is still the North Hadley Fire Station. And again, that was just being leveraged. And
the only thing that I might possibly disagree with that is I know CPA is going to be, or that the school will be looking for CPA money to, and it's a finite, it's just like everything else, a finite number of money.
Yeah.
But they'll be looking to try to, I think, jumpstart getting the fields started on the piece of property that was traded with the trustees to finally get something going there after many long years of not going forward with
it. Right, so it may be coming along because it's due, but I'm not saying that it wasn't, let me back up. I don't mean to say that it's not important, but it's coming because it's due. It's been out there a long time. It just wasn't an initial priority. Finding recreational fields is not an initial priority for us.
Yeah, I mean, you know, in a perfect world, I would have stood up at that town meeting article and described that the town or the MBC needed 3 acres of that parcel for a fire substation. And then I would have had my counterpart at Park and Rec saying, we would like the remaining parcels for recreational use, and this is why, and this is how we're justifying it. We've spoken to CPA, they've agreed with us, and you know, I mean, we didn't, actually, I don't think it really falls within our purview to program the rest of that site, you know, because
well,
we don't need it for town buildings.
No, I agree, but that parcel came in at the RFP when? April 15th, right?
Yeah,
so,
yeah, I know.
You know, that really wasn't time
was
to
strange
develop
timing.
That,
yeah.
That program.
But I'm not sure you would have identified that as a priority for Park and Rec, given the fact that you may have some access to the fields at Hopkins when they're constructed, or Zaterka Park is now part of the
equation. Well, I think what started this discussion was that I thought it might behoove the select board to consider executing that initial RFP if they're going to consider pursuing a North Hadley fire substation, just to see what else is out there for options. And we know that there's at least two parcels. One came in under a different RFP. There's, and there may be even more, as our hound here is good at ferreting out, but...
And what would that, be a 3-acre lot for a substation, or what is it that you're looking for? What would the RFP be for?
That's what it would be.
The substation.
Exactly what you described.
Okay.
Which we talked about all year ago.
The parameters that we originally provided for the RFP.
Plus 3 acres minimum.
That is still somewhere.
Or, but possibly more, obviously, but...
So that at least give us more options other than North Hadley Hall. And that was, and actually probably would be a better site than what was currently being proposed, so... I think we would like to, as a committee, see that, and I don't know if I want to speak for everybody, but at least have the option.
Well, I mean, it takes time for the administrator, Mr. Nixon, to put these together. I recognize that, but it would provide us with some opportunities to compare sites and come up with a good scenario for the long term.
We agreed with the concept, we explored it, and Mr. Michkowski's bringing it back before. We rejected it a while back because of a number of reasons. So I don't think all of those have gone away either. So it's, you know, you're looking at saving the cost of the land. Well, you heard me say it before.
Well, actually, so. The RFP was written, if I recall, and it just didn't go out. So it just needs to get followed up on and
that's good.
Get it going, if that's what the select board chooses to do.
It sounds like this committee recommends, Jerry, that we pursue that.
Pursue it with a 3-acre as the original proposal was drafted.
3-acre minimum.
Provide us some options in North Hadley.
And that's the minimum, so if they have 10, all the better.
That property may not be available in longer. They've taken it out of 21, 61A, and he was going to call.
The town's got right of first refusal if they're asking to take it out of 61A.
They've already taken it out.
They can't.
They can't take it out until they get the...
Can't get the refusal? Well, then the guy was... Real estate agent was giving a...
He doesn't know.
And when you go into 61A, the only way to come out is to offer it to the town. That's town has right of first refusal on that for the fair market value of the property.
And we have a specific amount of time to make that decision.
125 days.
Okay,
good.
And that could get us to town meeting.
So here we are again, 8:45, and we haven't gotten to the recommendation plan.
Really
going to try and clear the agenda next time. No, this was, I mean, every time, it's important. I mean, you know, we don't spend as much time complaining as we used to, but we still do a little of that. But anyway, to the point of the old business was that my understanding from the select board is they're looking for a recommendation report sometime in June. Jerry, maybe you can hone in on the deadline, but...
I'm more specifically, and that's not to put unfair parameters on you guys either.
Not at all. We understand. We've been trying to advance that report for some time now. In fact, you have in front of you a kind of the bones of a recommendation report, just simply outlining the sections. You know, I get into initially what our charge was and the intent of the report, the work plan, the initial findings and conclusion, and then ultimately an implementation plan by year. So I really want to make this very graphic about how we would advance individual projects and when to the level of detail where we would actually have an authorization schedule, which you can see on the last page, which would recommend when and where certain town warrant articles are approved, you know, which years, because we recognize through this process we're at the mercy of the spring and fall meetings, and, you know,
yes, you could have a special one necessary, mm-hmm. but
right, we could, but generally we've held to those dates, and it's driven our schedule to a large extent. So, but yeah, I just kind of drafted this up for all of you to look at. I know that Tim, you had started a very good first draft of a report a while back, and I emailed you yesterday just to see if you could maybe get some of that to me so that I could populate some of these categories. Understood.
So I can get that over to you for our next meeting. We can put some thoughts into this. And
yeah, I just,
this.
Exactly. You know, I'll continue to build this, but I just recommend that you look at it. Look at the table of contents on the first page and see if there's some things that you think should be included here. I mean, obviously, the meat of it is the recommendation plan, and Tim put together a couple of scenarios, which I think is really just a follow-through of our two options that we had discussed.
I can email that to everybody again, and we can start really seriously putting this together.
Yeah.
And this is on email?
Not yet, but I can forward that to you right now. Sure.
Yeah, and then that way we can all look at it and try to compile our thoughts.
Is there any initial thoughts on the report, you know, the format, anything?
I like it. This is a great start.
Yeah, this is a good outline.
Yeah, I like this.
I don't think it needs to be as elaborate as the one you sent around the other night in the email.
Oh, no, not at all. You might have seen some examples I sent. There was one. There was one that was clearly the volunteers that were on that committee had more time or
than we have.
They had a professional doing it. I don't know which,
yeah,
but
yeah,
that paid by the word.
I was really impressed. There's no way we could do that, I'm afraid.
We could
drawings
try.
And everything. We'd have to hire the project consultant, and then it would be done next year, not this year. Okay, so let me know if there's anything that we should add.
Well, and we're talking about different concepts or scenarios, and I haven't read through this.
No, just got handed it, so.
It might help simplify it if we have, you know, plan for the building up front, or in some part of this, each of these buildings that you've listed out.
You mean the physical plan, or you mean the recommendation?
A recommendation.
Oh, all right,
you know,
okay.
Like option one, if option one is to build a new library and build a new senior center, what happens to the existing building? You know, demolished, relocated, something along those lines. To keep it, you know, at least programmatic and what's going out with the buildings that we have. I don't know, you guys think that's
one of my reports, that's sort of what I did. I said, if we do this, then, I mean, take what I have and just read it through and put your own thoughts and mix it around.
A few months ago, it was good, but yeah, it was very good. But I mean, it's certainly a start, and you had the public safety complex. It was hinging on that, if I recall, whether or not we were going to turn it into a community center or.
But like I said, we should always present the two options.
And what has been nagging at my mind around that scenario is the whole North Hadley Fire Substation and whether or not how that plays into it.
I mean, that is the recommendation of our fire chief for the time being, when we have all on call and everybody's up there, it's a priority that we have that. And I think everybody's agreed to that to some extent.
But this committee's agreed to it, so it's part of our recommendation plan.
Right, so we need to include that. Remember, I think that was my reply to your original plan, is we just got to add that whole program into it.
Yeah. Okay, that sounds good. What do you all think about just doing a special meeting at some point, clearing the boards? We skipped all the business and updates from committees, and
I was just going to suggest that. Just go right to that straight.
Amen. We nail it, and we start from
my second
plan A.
Yep.
Okay, I think that would be to our advantage.
In fact, our next meeting is the extra Monday of the month, if you wanted to.
Which Monday? Is that next week?
Yeah, no.
The fifth Monday?
Fifth Tuesday.
It's a Tuesday.
It's 31st.
Okay.
The day after Memorial Day.
Yeah. Well, let's try and find something on the calendar that works for everybody. If that's the date.
Yeah, maybe have it on the calendar.
So that's the 31st.
Right. I mean, we've settled for two per month, but this would be the extra. This might be a good time to tackle that.
Okay. Are you all available on the 31st for that meeting? Full group?
I may have a son flying in. I just don't know what time.
Just one son?
Just one son.
That's enough sometimes.
Takes up a lot of my time, though. But I just know what his flight time is, so that may take me out of the loop. But
it's important for me to have all of you at that meeting. Yeah. So if we have to move it, I'm willing to do that as well. But let's
plan on the 31st for now.
Yeah. Okay.
It works for everybody.
So I'm going to clear all other business from that meeting, and if there's anything in the interim that the library needs or anyone else needs, we can deal with it, but just want to focus, which we haven't done, so.
Well, and we're meeting the following Monday anyway.
Right, and that's going to be necessary to hone in on the plan and then draft it and then refine it and get it to the select board the following week.
Right, but you're saying we could deal with anything. I'd say we defer all other business till.
No, I just meant in the interim if there was anything, email or whatever.
So we got a lot of homework.
Right. Yeah, so you're going to get me what you have. It would be useful to have some of the PDFs of those surveys and things, just to sort of add in appendixes and all that too. You know, I haven't seen the surveys that we requested for Town Hall and for Russell School.
Okay.
Right, we did pay for those, we got them surveyed, there's probably a PDF of the files.
Yes, I got PDFs made of those, I think.
I did start to make a list of the things that we recognized we didn't have, like those and the seismic studies and some other things that we all decided as a committee was necessary to make our decisions. So I want to have those as part of the document.
We have that listed so people know what.
Yeah. And those are listed here in case anyone is curious. Okay, good.
I will update, the window quote has come back and we've got that in the works. As soon as they can get it made up, those are going in at the garage.
Good.
And the bids are out second time around for the HVAC controls, so.
How about the pole line?
That's in progress. We're going to get going.
Just a general update, I think, didn't you say at some point we had like 35 projects completed or something like that, wasn't there?
That was the initial tally, yeah.
We can do a.
It's really, you know, let's get that out there.
I'll put it on the Facebook page.
I'm sorry, but, you know, I'm getting.
It's just like, I'm going to have to do it like five or six at a time.
I'm watching people say that we're lacking, people are lacking confidence in the committee, right? But I think, in essence, we've really produced a lot of success stories here, so.
And I don't think town meeting was, again, a rebuke, because we really didn't, you know, it said that the town meeting, it was stated the town meeting voted down everything we suggested, and.
We really didn't suggest.
Really, I think there's some misconception out there about who was behind what articles, and.
I think we had one article that we voted, that we advocated for, and it passed, so we're one for one.
The transfer of the money.
OPM.
OPM, that's right.
Still bad at those.
Yeah.
So speaking of which, Jerry, do you think it'd be important for us to be at the meeting, your meeting tomorrow night?
I would hope I could convey this conversation, and that's why I asked for what you guys are doing. I mean, I know you guys got to go to plenty of meetings, and if you find out tomorrow night I don't do a good job representing you down here, then Willie usually shows up to visit us, and then as soon as he leaves.
Well, as long as Willie's watching.
Start the meeting.
Yeah. Jerry, you've been here. Everybody's been here the whole meeting, and that's, we appreciate the fact that you guys have been.
Yeah, definitely. All to do it. Yeah.
Good.
Burnout time for you.
No, meetings. Mr. Danley will express to me how important this was.
I might be being nice.
That's all it took.
He's tired.
Okay, so next meeting, the 31st of May, Tuesday, we have this location. And then the follow-on meeting is a week following that, where we'll hone in on this plan. So next meeting, we clear the boards, we work it out.
Good.
Okay, good. Good. Do I have a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Second. In a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Hearing none opposed, we're adjourned. Thank you very much. Thanks for your.